Welcome to BPTV. I'm your host, Andy Amrine, and this is another of our Around Town. Today, we're following the process of our great dear friend, Johno Prascak, and his artwork about the steel mills. And today's progression brings us to the Carnegie Library in Homestead. Here we are, they're finding a home to be on display to the general public. So I'm looking forward to showing you a little bit about the hanging of it and why we have picked this location. So thank you for watching BPTV. And as you can see, very exciting moment, the artwork is actually being installed. So our friends are here, putting the holes in the wall, hanging the pictures, and finding it to a nice location over the doorways to the music hall of the Carnegie Library of Homestead. So a lot of fun. You don't usually get to see this part of it, but here they are hanging these unbelievable paintings. Johno, this has to be an exciting day. Has to be an emotional day. Walk us through the process. I see your friends are putting up, I think, number six right now.
Number six.
Out of the eight absolutely amazing paintings. Walk me through what you're feeling today.
A gamut of emotions. I feel like I'm home, personally, and also the paintings are home. I was born in Munhall. I spent the first 3 years of my life right up on the hill, Marham Road, and I was baptized at St. Teresa's Church.
Okay.
And then I grew up in Dormont, and then we live on the south side slopes, but this is a journey back home. The mills used to be right down the road here in the valley.
Okay. And with that, though, how did this location, you know, how did it happen? Did you contact them? They contact you? Tell us how this whole process worked that these paintings are actually being hung here at outside the Carnegie Music Hall at the Carnegie Library.
Sure. Started back in 2007. I was commissioned by the library board here. I did a painting of the building. It's called the Carnegie Library Homestead. And it hangs in the library.
And it still hangs in the library.
16 okay. years later, I'm quite honored.
Okay, Johno, while we're here at Carnegie Library,
yes.
Okay, why don't you tell us about this painting. This is an original,
yes.
This painting that's here at the library. How did this come to pass?
Sure. Back in 2007, Kate Grammerman, the executive director then, and the board, they commissioned me to paint the building. They saw my artwork somewhere, and they said, we want to hire Johno. My roots are from here. I was quite honored.
Mm-hmm.
So they let me, there was 15 board members. Everybody said yes. You got the whole board to agree, which is wonderful. And then Kate said to me, I'll never forget this. She says, make our building sing. And that's, if you look there, that was the defining moment of that.
Mm-hmm.
And then so this is through the History Club too of Steel Valley. So they commissioned me and they hung it here permanently. So they helped me out, but I wanted to help them out because why wouldn't you help a library out?
Right.
Libraries are part of the community.
Libraries are the center of the community.
Center of the community. I agree. So we did an edition of prints. It escapes me how many. It was maybe 500 or maybe more. The library got 80% of the prints. So to this day, 16 years later, there's two types of prints, the signed numbered and the smaller one. They sell them and all the money goes back into the library. And I got goosebumps.
Wonderful.
Again. If we help out, do our part, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. So
yeah.
Just another reason why your artwork finds its way home here.
And my roots are home again, times three.
Yeah. Now, Johno, are prints still available?
Yes, they are to this day. Okay. They contact the Carnegie Library Homestead. They have them here on site.
Okay.
And then through the course of the next 16 years, they followed my work, some of the folks over here, kindly. And they ended up, they got, when we were on TV with Bethel Park TV and also KDK and other and the Bethel Park Historical Society, they got a whiff of these steel mill paintings.
Okay.
And how about they approached me and said, I basically needed a 40-foot wall inside secure area.
Right.
And then we brought one of the canvases here a little while back, and it fit perfectly in this lobby of the music hall.
Okay. And so there you go.
There you go. That's in a nutshell. That's how.
Okay, but the colors of the paintings to the colors of the wall, the ceiling, it's as if it was always meant to be. I mean, the colors you picked for the canvases, for the mural of the mill and so forth, this really, just watching them go up, I'm just in awe as to how everything fell in place, and like they were called home.
It was like a revelation. I have no idea, because when I did these paintings, I didn't know they were going to end up here.
Right.
And it's just one of those things. It was meant to be. And I don't know how else to say it.
So now they're going to have a grand unveiling coming up shortly. But you know, what are the plans going forward with this? Are these here for a week, a day, a couple months? What do you think is going to happen with them here? Or ultimately, what are you looking for to happen?
Well, this library is celebrating 125 years here in Pittsburgh, in Homestead, Munn Hall.
Wow.
And the kickoff celebration is January 21st. So that ties in my paintings with that.
Okay.
So they wanted to unveil them. I've partnered with them, and it makes a lot of sense. And why not?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a wonderful thing. And they'll be on display for a minimal 2 months, perhaps longer. And then they are for sale. And then the library will get a percentage of that.
Wonderful.
Right.
Okay, so hopefully this might be a permanent location but at least in the meantime, you know, people have a couple months that they could come down and see all 8 of them together.
Yes.
How they were meant to be.
Which is awesome. This journey, the idea was get them out in public like we've done with you guys.
Right.
And this makes so much sense, this next step.
There's not many places you have a 40-foot wall that you can display a piece of artwork, is there?
Inside.
You know, inside.
In a secure area.
You know,
not a tent.
But even with the ledge and the ceiling and the marble, everything in this building.
It's perfect.
It really is perfect.
Yeah.
It's as if these were meant to be.
Right. If I may add a little note to my personal journey here. Like I said, I'm from this area in Pittsburgh. My grandfather, who came from Slovakia, was just so happy to make a better life for himself and us, like all of our ancestors. And my dad said years ago, he didn't mind working 12 hours a day. And this is before the 40-hour work week. He said, whatever he escaped in Europe, it was pretty bad. He never talked about it, but he was happy to come here and work. And then they went to the 40-hour work week, and he thought he died and went to heaven.
Yeah.
So what he did, he collapsed in the mill in 1950, right down here, in this mill, and he died a week later, his home in Munn Hall. I was born 9 years later, so I felt this connection to my ancestor I never met. Fast forward, become an artist. I says, once I found out 10 years ago, my personal journey of this, there's been artists that painted parts of this mill, but my question I needed in my mind is, any artist painted the whole shebang, the whole mill? And the answer was resounding no, and that's what got me clicking. My wife will testify to that, Maria, about, yeah, are you gonna do this, whatever? So that was my journey, doing the research. So during this painting process, which you kindly have been documenting, thank you again, Bethel Park TV, I felt the spirit. I felt like I knew my grandfather. I met him. We're talking, maybe having coffee and a beer or a sandwich, and that I never felt before. So this connection with art has really been helpful to me. I wasn't looking for a healing process or anything, but it was just wonderful. But also, I've connected, I feel, with the spirits of the town, the butcher, the bakers, the candlestick makers, everybody, not only the mill workers, but the whole compass of the community, including the library. And and art should speak to you, or maybe you feel something. Well, I've never felt the emotions all the way around, and they're very good emotions. So, and I kept hearing my grandfather and other people, Johno, get do this, get this done. You know, and I thought, that's so cool. And then my dad's long gone, and he would have loved this too, but you know, I feel his spirit. So it's all positive, fun.
So how far from where you're standing now was the mill that your grandfather was working at?
You could probably roll a couple monkey balls. This is Pittsburgh, right down the road. It'll go right in there, yeah, not that far.
So
right,
it's really just a couple blocks, towards the river.
It's right there.
From where we're standing is where this mill was and where your grandfather worked.
Yes, and these paintings mirror that valley.
Yeah, that valley.
And I never saw that coming until a few weeks ago.
Look one way at the prints, we can turn around and look towards the river, and you can envision everything as to what it was.
Right. And also, too, I want to add another note. My medium is I use enamel paints, and I use Monongahela sand.
Okay.
And then when I do special commissions or special paintings, which they all are, I was able to get, there's Monongahela sand, but I was able to get mill site sand from the mill in each one of these canvases,
pictures.
Documented on the back. And I think that's a nice organic telling of the story.
Right.
So, pretty good. Woohoo.
Brings everything together today, doesn't it?
It does. It's awesome. So, I could smell like sauerkraut and pierogies waffling through the hallways right now.
So, this process started when?
It's thought about it for 10 years.
Okay.
The physical process, about 3.5 years ago.
3.5 years ago.
Almost 2 years to paint. We're here today.
Yeah. So we've been following you for over 2 years on this journey. So
I'm honored. I couldn't ask for
it. You don't look a day older.
Oh, well, thank you. You're very kind. Neither do you.
Thanks.
And while I'm still alive, which I plan to be, you're still a young man to me because you're younger than me.
That's it, exactly. Well, Johno, thank you for sharing this journey. And looks like number 8 is going up right now.
Wow, how about that? So a shout out to the workers over there taking care of this here. So, and there's Maria back there.
So number 8.
Yeah, number 8.
And we're going to get the whole view. So.
Yes, thank you very much. Yep. And God bless.
It just makes more sense. And also a part of that, it's called Carnegie Steel-Homestead Works, 1926. And what I found out through the historians, U.S. Steel bought this plant off of Carnegie in 1901. So it became U.S. Steel, but they didn't put the logo of U.S. Steel on until the 50s. So this logo here, I love that. It says Carnegie Steel Company. So that was on the buildings at that time, because this is 1926, it would have been U.S. Steel. So I said, I'm doing a historical thing, but I have artistic license. And again, I'm not, if the historians want to pick me apart, go ahead. This is my interpretation. But so I was looking for a logo, and I was going to put U.S. Steel. They said U.S. Steel logo did not go on to the 50s.
Okay.
So back then, so that logo is correct from the Carnegie area, and they left it on there in the 20s.
Oh.
And I just love that. See, the Carnegie Steel.
Yeah, the C with the S. Yeah.
And then also, too, there's 241 smokestacks, which I didn't give you. I don't want to paint another smokestack in the near future. It's 241.
In this painting itself.
All 8 of them. And also, too, back then, pollution was everywhere.
Yeah.
So if I put all the pollution in, you're not going to see anything.
Right.
So how do you do it, make it look smoky, but you don't want to cover the buildings?
I think you nailed it.
Yeah.
I think you really did.
Then also, too, if you look at one painting by itself, you don't know it's connected to anything else.
Right, right. But with them all here together, it's just amazing.
Well,
it really is.
I hope this finds, this could be a permanent home. I hope it does.
It's beautiful. It really is.
Johno, 1 through 8, you're looking at it on the wall now.
Yeah.
Tell me what you feel.
Well, right off the bat, goosebumps and my heart on my sleeve.
Okay.
They did their job.
The whole thought of your paintings, they came home.
They are
this
home.
This is where they always belong.
They are home.
It's just the look of them in the lobby, over the doorways. It's breathtaking.
Thank you. When I started this, I never could imagine. I did this on my own. I never knew that they would fit here so perfectly.
Yeah.
I mean, it's...
Well, even from the dimensions, the height of the paintings, they are an apt... They came home.
Well,
that's all I keep,
it's
going
home.
To me.
I call it home
two
ways.
Where...
My roots and also the paintings.
Yeah.
It's a 2-for-1 for me. I'm quite honored, and let's let it take on a life of its own with all the public coming through here. How about that?
You happy?
I'm very happy.
Yeah.
Over the moon.
Well,
Bethel Park moon.
There you go. Well, thank you, everyone. Thank you very much for watching BPTV.
Yeah.
I'm your host, Andy Amrine, my dear, dear friend, Johno Prascak, and we'll see you around town soon.
And also, go Carnegie Library, Homestead, and Music Hall.